I'm Henny Espinosa, and this is your TFC News Now. We begin in Delaware for the first ever criminal prosecution of a sitting U.S. president's child.
On Tuesday, President Joe Biden's son, 53-year-old Hunter Biden, pleaded not guilty to charges he lied about his drug use while buying a handgun in 2018. This is the first criminal prosecution of an adult child of a sitting president who is campaigning for re-election. Hunter, who has publicly discussed his substance abuse, never held a position in the White House or on his father's campaign. He also has no prior criminal record. Filipino-American Carl Cancino, a former assistant district attorney, tells ABS-CBN News that had Hunter Biden been a regular citizen, his case would have unlikely made it to the prosecutor's office.
On a scale of 1 to 10, if I were representing Hunter Biden, unless this thing is purely driven by politics, then he should expect to get probation or reduced sentence, because that's what's commensurate with other sentencing of the same kind of offense that other people are getting. So you want to make sure his lawyers will make sure that he's not treated more unfairly than any other defendant just because of his last name.
Meanwhile, the issue of gun control is once again before the U.S. Supreme Court as it starts a new term this week.
The conservative majority court is scheduled to weigh in on whether people accused of domestic violence have a right to own a firearm.
There's a possibility here for a Supreme Court decision saying that removing guns from domestic abusers is unconstitutional, and that's something that we don't want to happen.
Filipino-American Robert Shentrop is a founding member of Team Enough, a youth-led gun violence prevention organization, a cause that he took on since 2018 after surviving a school shooting in Parkland, Florida.
Dude, I think we got shots fired. Hostile shots fired.
Shentrop's sister Carmen and 16 other students and staff were killed that day by a lone gunman. Recently, President Joe Biden announced the first ever Office of Gun Violence Prevention, a welcome news for Shentrop and others who have been advocating for such an office.
And finally, we hear about FilAm musician Alex Ritchie's inspiring journey from years of rejection to the Grammys.
When she was starting out in 2008, Alex Ritchie was told that Asian artists like her will never be successful.
When you're hearing that from like the top of the top, and it seems like it's this belief that so many people at the top have, how do you ever expect to change their mind?
But instead of giving up, she persevered as an independent artist and eventually caught the eye of the Recording Academy and several music industry power players. Her life changed when she became part of Grammy U, the Recording Academy's mentorship program that helps young talents who are actively pursuing music careers. She became the youngest sitting committee member in the history of the Recording Academy's Los Angeles chapter, where she advocated for LGBTQ+ and Asian American representation. In 2022, Ritchie joined the Gibson guitar family as an official Gibson artist.
I just gotta go home. We already.
She recently released her new single, Go.
And those are the news making headlines today. You can catch more TFC News on the ABS-CBN News website, YouTube channel, and app. I'm Henny Espinosa. Stay with us, Kapamilya.